Okay, so what can we do for our Coast Guard for now? Clearly, the Coast Guard needs support. They need assistance with what we're experiencing in the West Philippine Sea. So what's available?
Right. I mean, there are in the pipeline acquisitions. I need not mention all these things, but there are ongoing projects to support the operations of the Philippine Coast Guard.
Like what?
I mean, acquisition of more floating assets. And
so you mean ships? Discussion. You mean ships?
Yes. Yeah. And then acquisition of assets. We are also discussing with friendly foreign partners and for a development of a major Coast Guard base in the country. So these are things that we can expect.
Okay. Would you have a number? I mean, I know that... I've spoken with the Philippine Coast Guard. I believe that there are three major ships, and I think there are, 10 others. But then I know that, for example, China has 30 ships out in Ayungin and Sabina. So, I mean, have you had a dialogue about this? Do you have a target for next year?
Yeah. I'm actually, we were in discussion with the Philippine Coast Guard. There is that vision of having a big vessel for each of the 15 districts of the Philippine Coast Guard. So that is a goal. Of course, budget constraints would have to be faced as well. But that's just basically to give you and the viewers an idea of what we wish to accomplish for the Philippine Coast Guard.
Mm-hmm. Okay, now let's move on to the Filipino Seafarer Certification. Let's talk about that for now. I know the Seafarers' Rights Bill has also passed in the lower house so far, but in terms of the certification, sir, what would be, what's new with that now that would benefit our seafarers?
Right. It's good that you mentioned the bill for seafarers, for the protection of seafarers. That's one thing, and the certification is a totally different thing, although they are related. Mm-hmm. Well, as you know, we have been undergoing audits and inspections from the Europeans and from the IMO itself. We are a member state of the IMO, so we have to comply with the regulations with the international standards. As mentioned before, the Philippines has not failed these audits or inspections. There were concerns raised, and these are being addressed. And we are working hard, the Marina, for example, and together with Ched, we are all working hard to be able to address these concerns. Mm-hmm. Compliances have been done, and we continue to pursue the corrective actions we indicated in our reports. So we are hopeful that within the year, when we expect the decision to come out, that we can expect something positive.
Okay. Now, in the Seafarers' Rights Bill, there will be a certification system, right, that meets international standards. What kind of system do we need, since the Philippines is one of the largest sources of seafarers in the world?
Yeah. I mean, the thing is, there are certifications in the STCW Convention. Mm-hmm. So the bill for seafarers it's expected to reflect these requirements from the international conventions.
All right. Well, I guess on that note, I want to thank you so much for your time, sir. DOTR Assistant Secretary for Maritime, Julio Siano. Thank you for joining me today.
Thank you also. Good morning.